He said it just happened all nothing. You know about it. I ain't supposed to do that. And God took it. Now I know when God took it away, he was gone.
Amen.
And I ain't smoked in 30 years.
Amen.
I ain't had his eyes smoked. So when God take it out, he take the very taste out.
Yes,
and he takes it by the wood. See, you got weed that grow, right? Why they keep on growing? Because the root is still up in there somewhere. But when God get it, he get it by the root. Take it all the way out of your honey. He take the bad desire out of you. That's how God grows, honey. Because if you let some root there, you don't go back and get it. But he take it by the root. You ever use weed killer?
Yes, sir.
It get it by the root. You put weed killer on them. On sin killer. That's what he did with us, honey. He worked us over. When God did the work, we are his workmanship. You can't do it yourself. I just tried to put smoke on several cans without success. But when I got serious about it, I wanted to be saved. God took it just like that.
Yeah.
And when he took out the very taste of it. Go ahead. If any man have a quarrel against man, either look here, if we don't get along. And I'm going to tell you something else. Don't prejudge looking at folks thinking that you won't get along with them. That might be your best friend.
Amen.
Come on now. That's right.
Come on.
Y'all might have something in common.
Mm-hmm. Come on.
I don't prejudge folks.
That's right.
That might be the one, that might be the best friend you got in church.
Right. Right.
Y'all might have 90% things in common to one another. That's a bad thing to do too. People prejudge one another. Even as Christ forgave you, you ought to do the same thing. Forgive me. Go ahead.
And above all these things, put on charity, which is the bond of perfection.
Above all else, we gotta have love for one another.
Amen.
And you better love the sinner. Better love the sinner too.
Amen.
Cause you better love everybody.
Amen.
Come on. Only one person you can hate.
Yes.
The devil.
That's right.
And all his angels.
Everybody's one of them.
Now God didn't say, devil, you get out of here.
No.
I'd be the devil, he kicked him out of here. And the devil probably said, ouch! He bumped his head when he hit her, didn't he? God is good all the time. Yeah. Above all things, put on charity. Go ahead.
And let the peace of God rule in your heart, to the which also ye are called in one body. And be ye thankful.
Let the peace of God, let the peace of God rule.
Rule.
Yes.
Not your natural man.
Amen.
Let the peace of God rule what? In your heart. Let the peace of God rule. Let the word of God have preeminence in your life. That's what he's saying. Let the peace of God rule so you can overcome the obstacles of the enemy that come against you. Come, devil, come here and say, and the devil spread rumors on
him. Yes,
he will. He'll say, yeah. he'll say, ain't nobody ain't said nothing. Just say, they don't like you.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
Sure will.
Yeah.
Like you. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And if you weak, you be saying,
what
you say? I said, they don't like you. And you acting up on
them.
The devil get you in trouble.
Come on.
And make you look like a knucklehead. in the church. And then you're going to react to it. And the next day they might come and say, hey, my brother, I love you.
Right.
Now, how you going to feel about that?
Right.
You're going to feel like a skunk.
Right.
Let the peace of God rule to which you are called one body and be what? Amen. Thankful. And a lot of folks ain't thankful for nothing.
Oh, wow.
The Bible says people be content with such things as you have.
Amen.
Go ahead.
Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly in all wisdom.
Dwell in you richly what? In all what? Wisdom.
Teaching and admonishing one another. In psalms and hymns and spiritual songs. Singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord.
Let the word of God dwell in you richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. We ought to be happy when we come to church.
Amen. Amen.
Some folks come to church and got other things on their mind.
Yes, come on.
Some folks come to church and got what they're going to eat tomorrow for lunch.
Yes, come on. Amen.
And what they're going to wear tomorrow and all they're going to carry on. And they're missing their blessing.
Come on.
They're coming today. Tomorrow might not come.
Amen.
They ought to be happy for today. Day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. God, think about other stuff coming to church.
Yeah.
Come to church, see how much money they got in the bank. All the old Karen on him. Thinking all kinds of stuff.
Yeah.
And God might want to bless you, but God, now the hobo, see, he sees what you think, and then he's going to what? He gonna jump over you and get the next person. Because you think about something else. That's how you miss your blessing. Go ahead.
And whatsoever ye do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God and the Father by him.
Ooh, whatever you do in word or deed, do in the name of the Lord Jesus, give thanks to God and the Father by him. And Lord, be thankful for everything.
Amen.
Learn not to murmur, not to complain about nothing.
Come on.
And people now murmur, complain about everything.
Oh my God.
If it's cold outside, hear me. Hear me in Chicago in January, it's supposed to be cold.
Amen.
Amen. In Texas. You know what I'm saying? Right like that, Texas. Well, move to Texas. People complain about it. Get you a coat. They complain about that. And here it is, man. Here it is. We know January now in Chicago, it can get cold. It's supposed to be cold now, really. It can be cold for 7 months in Chicago. October, November, December, January, February, March, and sometime April. About 7 months, it can be freezing. And people in Chicago all night and complain about 15 degrees below zero.
Come on.
Like it just started last year. It's been like that since the world been here. I love Chicago myself, man. I love when it get cold too, man, because there ain't no terms in there.
Right.
I'm good all the time. You can't stand the heat, get out the kitchen. I'm good all the time, man. Whatsoever you do in word, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God and the Father by him. God is good all the time. I'm still going, but I'm gonna cut it off right now. Amen. Thank God for holiness. Amen. Thank God for getting us saved. Amen. Thank God for Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of our faith, who for the joy that set before him endured the cross, despite the shame, was on the right hand of the Father, making intercession for the saints. He neither sleep nor slumber, and his word is forever settled in heaven. God is a good God all the time. Just hail this old him. It says, Father, peace with all men, but I wish no man to go to see the Lord. God is good all the time. We shouldn't be arrogant and spreading against one another. The Father Christ will come. Who else we got to go to? He that wants friend must first show himself friend. God is good all the time, honey.